Hello friends, welcome to my videos. So in this video I'm going to show you how to submit an online open work permit application for Canada. Before I proceed further, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe because I regularly upload videos, and if you have any concern, any question, anything that you want to ask, feel free to ask. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So in front of you I have logged in into my MYCIC account. I just created a name Winner Smith just to demonstrate you. And I'm gonna show it to you. Of course I'll not go to the last page where the payment is done, but before that I'm gonna show you everything that I can. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So suppose in this case this guy Winner Smith, this guy is applying for an open work permit to Canada based on his spouse who is studying in Canada. Okay, it could be like her spouse working in Canada as well on a work permit, so he becomes eligible for open work permit, or he is working in Canada and then he is applying for a bridging open work permit. We are going to select that option. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So first thing he needs to do is to click here, apply to come to Canada. So because we do not have created any personal reference code, so let's create it. I don't have personal credit, then go for here. So what would you like to do in Canada? You would like to work here. How long you're planning to stay temporarily? More than 6 months. So suppose this guy holds an Indian passport. I select India. What is the current country or territory? Suppose he is in India. Do you have a family member who is against your permanent residence? So let's say no, because we are assuming that this guy's spouse is studying in Canada on a student visa. What is your date of birth? So let's say this guy was born on 95, month January, day 1. Wow, a good birth date, isn't it? Next, he is not living in the States, so this is not applicable. He does not have a job offer in Canada. He selects no. Do you plan to work in the following categories? Athlete, coaches, aviation, business, civil, clerk, convention, emergency service examiner, expert, witness, healthcare, students, highly skilled worker and researcher, judges. Suppose none of this, let's go no. Now this question is very important. Will you be coming to Canada with a spouse or common law partner who is or will be working in Canada as a foreign worker, or who is or will be a full-time student at a university, community college? So we assume that this guy is like applying for a open work permit based on his spouse who is a student in Canada, so select yes. Are you of working age and a dependent person who is or will be working Canada full time? Say yes. Have you recently graduated from a participating Canadian post-secondary institute for which your study program was full time? So no, this guy is going to Canada for the first time, so we select no. But yes, when you fill up these, you should select based on your case. What is your matter? So he is married because his spouse is working. What is your province of destination? So suppose his spouse is studying from an eligible institute in Ontario. So I select Ontario. Next. So based on the information you provided, the result below indicates that you may be eligible to come to Canada. So this questionnaire is very important. Make sure you put the values according to your case, and then you are gonna see that under what category you can apply. So this guy can apply open work permit outside Canada. Continue. Again click on continue. Now this is asking what type of work permit you want to apply for. So in this case, this is going to be this one, work permit for a spouse, common law partner or child of a skilled worker or international student, because he is going to go as a spouse of an international student. Click next. Are you accompanying a family member that has status in Canada or has recently been approved to come to Canada? Select yes. Have you ever committed, been arrested for charge? So no criminal history? No. If you had a medical exam performed by an IRCC authorized person, no. So in this case, he will be asked to. Have you visited or lived in any of the designated countries for 6 months, 6 consecutive months in the last year? So select no. I mean, based on your case, but if you have done, put according to that. Do you want to work in one of the following jobs? Healthcare, clinical laboratory, patient attendant, medical student, medical teacher, primary, secondary school, domestic workers, day nurseries? Suppose no. Of course, it's going to vary case by case. Do you want to submit an application for a family member? Let's say no. Are you giving someone access to your application? Yes, I'll be appointed representative. Authorization to release your information to another person? Yes, both appoint a representative and grant authorization to IRC to another person. No, like you wanna do it yourself, but if you wanna authorize somebody, then you need to select accordingly. In the past 10 years, have you given fingerprint and photo for an application to come to Canada? This is for biometrics. Suppose no in this case, so go for no. There are fees associated with this application. Will you be paying your fees or are you fee exempt? Yes, he is applying from India. Are you able to make a digital copy of documents? So yes, because this is an online application. He is gonna scan and upload. Will you be paying your application fees online? Yes. They accept Visa, MasterCard, American Express, JCB, China Union or a debit card. Wow, a lot of payment options. You can review your answers once you are okay. Just click on continue. Now in this page, this is gonna show you the steps through which you can do it. So click on continue. So now you have come here on this page. I mean, this is in your here. You can see that there's a section for uploading documents, and at the end they have also shown you the total fee. So the total fee is 314 Canadian dollars. Alright guys, so let's proceed with all of these one after one. The first is application for work permit made outside of Canada. Let's click on it. It opens in a new tab, so it's fine. And my suggestion would be to use IE Explorer, because what happens is that sometimes in other browsers we see these forms do not open. So either you can download and then but if you are doing it like on browser, let's go for IE. That's more reliable for submitting IRCC applications based on my experience. Okay guys, so okay, let's proceed. Alright, so you see a unique client identifier. So this guy is applying for the first time. There's no UCI for him, so let's leave it. Let's go to the other fields. He wants services in English, so we are gonna select English here. Full name, so we assume this guy's name is Winner Smith. Have Have you used any other name before? No. But if yes, if you have used, you need to put. He's a male. Date of birth. Month 01, date 01. Suppose he was born in New Delhi. Make sure these details match with your passport. India. Citizenship. India. Current country, he lives in India. But like, you need to fill up as per your case. So this is just a sample case. Status, he's a citizen there. Previous country of residency, during the past 5 years, did have you lived in any country or territory other than your country of citizenship or your country territory of residence for more than 6 months? So if you have gone to any other country apart from your country of citizenship for more than 6 months in past 5 years, you need to put that details here. If not, select no. Country or territory we are applying, same, then yes. If you are in other country, then put that information. Your marital status, so we selected married. If you are married on a common ownership, provide the date. So what date would you guys suggest me? Let's say 2015, correct? 2015, again make it the 1st January. Is that okay guys? I think so. And there's a format of date and month. Make sure you follow this. Don't do any mistake here. Provide the name of your current spouse. Okay, so let's say his spouse name is Jessica Smith. Have you previously been married? No, this was his first time marriage. But if yes, if it is applicable in your case, put that information here. Native mother tongue, let's say his mother tongue is Hindi. Are you able to communicate? He can communicate in English. Have you taken test? No, he has not taken any test in the language. Selected no. Passport. Okay, let's say his passport is IND 123456. It was issued in India. And it was issued, when should I start? Let's say 2015. Yeah. 2015 0101 1st. And it is valid till 2025 0101. For this trip, will you use a passport issued by Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Taiwan? Not applicable. Same for Israeli, not applicable. That's why these options are already disabled. Do you have a national identity document? Let's say yes, because in India we have PAN card, Aadhaar card. Suppose he has Aadhaar card, so AD. I don't know the format of an Aadhaar card. So let's say this. But this is not mandatory. If you select no, these fields are going to be disabled. If you have, then put like PAN card. Like when I applied for my application for the first time, I used my PAN card and that was accepted. So let's say, when was it issued? Let's say it was issued in 2018. Some documents in India, like PAN card, there's no expiry date. So you don't need to worry about these fields are not mandatory. So if there's no expiry card, just the expiry, just leave it. USPR card. So he's not a green card holder. Put no. Contact information. Okay, let's say 100 New Delhi Street. He's in New Delhi. He's in India. Postal code. I don't know the postal code of Delhi, but let's go. District. Let's say New Delhi. Residential, stay same as mailing address. I select yes, because in most of the cases, otherwise no. Telephone number, Canada, US, other, because this guy is in India, so that's why residence. Country code, 91 number, 12345678 90. Again, alternate phone number, let's say he has a cellular number also. 91, this time just reverse it. 9876543210. Fax number, he doesn't have. Email address. Yeah, email address is very important, because they are gonna do a lot of communication on this about your application and all. So let's put the email address. Okay. Details of intended. What type of work permit you are applying? Okay, now here comes the actual question. Open work permit. You have this option of open work permit. Go for it. Details of my prospective employer. Attach original offer of employment. So in this case, you don't have an offer of employment. You don't have, a job offer. So these two you can skip it. Intended location of my employment in Canada. So you'll be working, let's say Ontario. So that you can put. This is intended where you will be working. City, town where you would be working. So let's say this guy is working in Toronto. What we saw that when we put these two, address became mandatory. So let's leave it because you don't have an offer of employment. My occupation in Canada, yeah, what should I say? Let's say taxi driver. Brief description, like provide this in details. So let's say driving taxis. I don't know about much about this. Driving taxis and anything else, I don't know guys, so leave it. But you need to duration of expected employment. This is very important. So ideally it should be because your spouse is studying. And let's say she has 2 years of study permit. So make sure you match with that. Let's say her work visa is expiring in 2021 in May 15. And let's say you wanna go there on, suppose today is 18th. So you are thinking that you can go there from 1st of June. Then after you are done with this, the next section is about your education. I just filled it up. So this is asking, have you had any post-secondary education including university, college or apprenticeship training? So suppose this guy had yes. So I filled, like suppose he studied from 2010 to 2014, Bachelor's of Science in New Delhi. So just fill this up. Employment. Do you give details of your employment for past 10 years including if you held any government positions. Suppose this guy was a cabbie and working for this company based cabbie. So I provided the details. Suppose he started working from 2014 May. So I put that information. Now background information is very important. Within the past 2 years, have you had or family had any tuberculosis? I selected no. Have you had remained validity of your status? No. So whatever is applicable in your case, like this is asking if you have overstayed your visa without authorization or have you been refused a visa or work permit, denied entry, anything to any country, make sure you select the appropriate answers and then provide information. Do not hide anything, do not misinterpret. Have you ever committed being arrested for being charged with or convicted of any criminal offense? So I selected no. Did you serve in military militia? I selected no. Any political affiliation? No. Have you participated or witnessed any ill treatment of prisoners, civilian? I selected no. Now here comes signature. So do you consent to be contacted by IRCC? Yes. Date you can select for today. Now when it comes to signature, like don't just print it and then sign it. I'll show you why. So this page from IRCC, how do I sign my online application? You have to type in your name and answer security question to submit your application. This is your electronic signature. So you don't need to worry about that field. So what we are gonna do, we are gonna put the name here. Let's say winner. Oh, sorry guys. Winner Smith. Date. And it's very important to click on validate, because then this is gonna validate your whole application and you're gonna get a message. If there's any error, it's gonna take you to the field where you have committed the error, and it's gonna generate barcode. So the next thing is to save it as a PDF. So I saved it as a PDF and I'm gonna now try to upload it. But what happens guys, like when you are idle for too long time from your MyCIC account, it locks you out. So you got to log back in with the account information you created and navigate till your application. So I logged in into my account again. You can see that in your MyCIC you have this application under pending. You can click on continue. It's going to ask you to review the answers that you submitted when you went for the wizard. Click on continue. Continue. And now you can upload the documents here. Click on upload file. My document is uploaded. Now return to your documents. Okay, so this turned green. So now we have to go for other documents. Let's say, let's go for family information form. Complete all names in English and in your native language. Include all family members even if they are not accompanying you. If additional space is required, print or attach the additional form. So how I filled it, like okay, I'll walk you through that. Let's proceed. So this guy is married physically present, and his name is Winner Smith. He is the applicant. Country of birth, India. He was born, see the date format, this is very important guys. 01. Present occupation, taxi driver. Address, I don't remember what I intended, but I just 100 new Delhi Street, India, and it was 831001. Okay, spouse. Let's say married already. Married, physically present, of course. And his name was Jessica Smith. Suppose she was also born in India. Let's make it I capital, it looks better. And her date of birth, let's say 1998, 1st August. Present occupation, let's say student. And now she is living in Toronto. So let's say right 50 Toronto Street, Ontario, M1W4ES. I just created one, don't follow this address. Will the company yes. Now mother, let's say his mother and father. Okay, she is married. His dad, both are married. Now I need to create two more names. Mother, so Tracy Smith. Daddy, John Smith. Both were born in India. So birth date, let's say mom was born in 1975, May, and Mr. Smith was born 1972, June 1st. Good date. So let's say Mr. Smith, he is acting, what could be his occupation? Let's say he's a teacher and Mrs. Smith is a housewife. Address, so suppose they are living at the exact same address and they are not accompanying you to Canada. So click on name. Okay, so if your no spouse are listed, you then you need to sign here, otherwise leave. Children, suppose these guys have no children, so they have to sign and date here. Date can be picked here. And section C needs to be mandatorily signed, that's important. Now there are certain things about this document. If you read here, if additional space is required, print and attach an additional form, because they should get all the details. So that's why this document you have to print. There are two reasons. First, if you need an additional space, and you need to put it in your native language as well, names. So what I did, that I'm going to share with you, that first I filled my document like this. I did have brother, I did not have any children and all, so this you leave it, and in that case you have to sign here also. And section C, I mean this guy, John will sign. So John, this guy, not John, sorry, Winner will sign section B and C because he does not have any children, and C is mandatory for all. And then what he is going to do, that he's gonna take a printout of this, sign and save it for a moment. Then again these names will be wiped out, because this document needs to be submitted in your native language also. And when you fill the other form, you selected your native language as Hindi, right? Whatever is applicable in your case. So what now he's gonna do, he's gonna take a printout again, sign in section B and section C, and using a black pen he's gonna write the information like his name, Winner Smith in Hindi, Jessica Smith in Hindi, John Smith in here in Hindi, Tracy Smith in Hindi. And again he's gonna take a scan, he's gonna combine both of these documents and upload. I hope you got this point. So this is a sample, that's why I'm not going into the details like how to combine files and all those things you can do. So now I uploaded this also. Next is to upload your passport, digital photo. So for passport, photo and all, there are guidelines. So you need to follow those guidelines. So I've opened the photo guidelines for you. This is available in the site and you can find it out here as well. And if you click on these questions, it's gonna tell you. All the details are here. Even the format of the file, size of the file. Like maximum 240 KB, but not less than 60 KB. Similarly for passport, if you click, any page, visa and stamp. And any other document. Alright guys, whatever is applicable. So I'm just upload some random files here and come back. So I have uploaded some random files here. Next comes is your proof of relationship. Marriage certificate, birth certificate. Alright guys, so I'm again gonna upload a random file. I have uploaded random files, but make sure you upload genuine files. Now this one is IMM 5257. Let's go for it. Alright guys, so indicate whether you are the principal applicant. Full name, Smith, Winner. This is your first application, you don't have any UCI, date of birth. let's say 1995 month 0101. Again, be careful with the format. Military sir, did you serve in military? Let's say no, he has never served. Have you ever witnessed an ill treatment prisoner? Let's say no. Go ahead. Have you ever been a member with any political party, group of organization? Let's say no. Have you ever held any government position such as civil servant, judge, police officer, mayor, member of parliament, hospital administrator? Let's say no government service or no. Since the age of 18 during the past 5 years, whichever is more recent, have you traveled to any country or territory other than the country of your citizenship? Let's say this guy has not traveled. If you have done, then put that information, and at the end you have this validate button. Click on validate. Now this form has been validated. Now save it as PDF. Click on upload file and just upload it. Now we are filling up this in the section of optional documents, but I always suggest go for it guys, because this is actually gonna provide information about your case. So in this client, you know, this is very important, so you need to provide a single document here. So what you can do, like, you can describe your case. For example, you're going for your spouse. So write it like this, that you are applying under the spouse category. The name of your spouse is this. She is studying here. Attach her documents, like her student contract letter, ID card, whatever she is studying, like college documents. I'm not sure of what documents we get here. That plus attach her passport, plus attach her study permit, and then based on that you make your case. I mean, if I'm a case officer, I get this client information. When I read it, I identify your case at a glance. Okay, the application is from Winner Smith. His wife is Jessica Smith. She's studying here. Okay, she has attached her college documents. Okay, she's a genuine student. She has a study permit. She's staying here. This is what she is doing. Like, full information should be there. And then once everything is uploaded, click on next. Now here comes the declaration and electronic signature. You select I agree. Signature name, signature. You need to write your first given name and last name. So this guy is Winner Smith. And there's a security question. Sorry guys, I don't want to show my security question to you, although you have seen already. And you have to click on this I agree. And this is the last screen. After this, you can click on transmit and pay. So in the next screen, you have to pay. So I'm not going to transmit and pay, of course. I'm going to end up over here. But I have tried to cover all the aspects. So I hope this helps you out, guys. So goodbye for now.